I love because it will enable my next new system. This is one of my best subjects ever. My favorite subject with my favorite teacher, Peter. How are you, sir?
Abraham, it's great to see you again. Absolutely. Years, it feels like ages since we've been on TV and talking to each other. In fact, it has been ages, but this is fine.
You must have.
But I always miss the pen. Always do. Always miss my teaching. Great to be back on it.
Awesome. What are we doing today?
All right. Well, we are going to have a fantastic program where we are going to talk about conversions as well as time conversions. Okay. Now, the one thing I've got to say to you viewers is this. That in these hour programs, we are going to cover a certain topic every week, and we're going to run through it from a grade 10, grade 11, and a grade 12 perspective. And guys, you need to understand something, that this year's grade 12 is working with the new CAPS document, okay? So it's a brand new pile of work that we're going to be throwing your way. So it should be great and interesting.
I think we've also been mentioning the studio because so many new guys in the studio.
We have, guys. We've got two new guys in the studio with us. We've got a guy called James.
How's it, James?
How's it?
And Mondi.
How's it, Bill?
They are actually very, very lucky because they actually happen to be some of my students.
Well, I don't know if that's lucky or unlucky.
Probably unlucky, but they won't ask it.
Oh, I don't know about that, but we won't ask them at all.
Okay. Guys, you are from? Okay, cool. I'm going to ask you just to look at the camera when you talk. Otherwise, everyone sees the side of your face, and that's not good advice. All right, so you're from St. Vivian's College. Now, St. Vivian's has a girls' college and a boys' college, all right? And I would presume you guys go to the boys' college.
Of course, of course.
Even though, I will say this, I've seen them more on the girls' side than the guys. Quite a bunch of Casanovas. A bit embarrassing, but we're not going to go there.
I don't know what you're doing, but tell us more about the challenge question.
Okay, we had a challenge question. Is it up here? I think it's up here somewhere. Let's go for it. Yeah, there's our challenge question. It's on the screen in front of you now, and I'll read it to you. It says, Candy is visiting her sister in the United States. She's driving on a road and notices that she's traveling at an average speed of 80 miles an hour. Given that 1 mile is 1.609 kilometers, determine if Candy will complete a trip of 420 kilometres by 4:30 p.m. if she left home at 1:13 p.m. So, guys, that's not a problem, man. That's a career. That's going to keep you going. And that's been posted up for, a good 4 or 5 days already? And I'm going to encourage you next week as well, we're going to have a challenge question, and it'll also be up on the website probably about Monday. Okay, talking of the website, I'm going to walk across to these guys and just give them something to do. While I get go there, you're going to tell people about the website. Okay, you go for it.
All right. My name is TuneIn. As you tune in right now, make sure that you go to facebook.com/thegamingstuff. Like the page and share on the page. I'm going to love to hear from you. And remember, the challenge question is already posted on our Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. I'll be reading some of your tweets at LearnExtra. And lastly, download channels all for free on Thank you,
all right, great guys. So here I am. What's it? The rose between the thorn bushes or something. Okay, but here we are. And guys, I'm going to give you a toss. Okay, and here's the toss. But today we're learning about conversions. And they're all different types of conversions we're going to look at. But I'm going to give these guys a project. And while I'm talking, every now and then the camera's just going to zoom in on these guys and see how they do it. Okay, but they're going to multitask. Which is quite difficult because I teach them and I'm not sure how good they're going to be at it. But what they're going to do is not only are they going to be building this thing, but they're also going to be helping me as I go through a few things. Guys, the task is simple. They don't know what the task is yet, so I'm throwing them in the deep end. Okay. You've got some paper. You can use as much paper as you want. All right? It'll only like 5 or 6 weeks, no more than that. Okay? Guys have done this with one sheet of paper, so it's quite possible. So you have a sheet of paper, you have a box of a pencil. I don't know where the other pencils went, but there's a pencil. We've got print glue, we've got some print stick, we've got a pair of scissors, we've got a ruler, and then, as well, which is kind of interesting, we've also got sellotape. And what you are going to do is you are going to make a box. It's got to be 10 centimetres long, 10 centimetres wide, and 10 centimetres high. We can do this?
We can.
Okay. You guys are matured students, so you should be good at this. So that's what they're going to do. Now, here's the trick. The idea of this whole exercise is to try and figure out how much water we can put inside a box that's 10 centimeters wide by 10 centimeters long by 10 centimeters high. Okay? So in other words, what I'm trying to tell you is, even though it's paper, it's got to be waterproof. Okay. And here's the real trick. When it comes to testing how waterproof this is, and when it comes to pouring the water into the box that you make, you've got to be so certain that it's waterproof, because we're going to get Ibrahim to lie on the floor, he's going to hold the box on his chest, and we're going to pour water into it. So if it's not waterproof, it's not going to be clean. I'm sure it can just be clear. Okay. All right, guys, you carry on with this. I'm going to go across there and catch you up here.
Well, Peter Gosley, I think I'm going to need some kind of experience with these guys. What do you think, Peter?
I think you can trust them,
man. These guys are Christian Okay. Right, so, our lesson today. In this lesson, we're going to revise how to convert measurements. Now, first, when I talk about measurements, we're going to look at converting millimeters to centimeters to meters to kilometers. We're going to look at converting grams and kilograms and maybe even to milligrams. But another thing we're also going to look at, we're going to look at two different types of measurements. We have a measurement system that we use in South Africa called the metric system. And then we also have a system that gets used, for example, in the United States called the imperial system. I'm sure you guys have heard about people talking and saying, oh, they were driving 500 miles an hour. And you're thinking, geez, what's a mile? We don't do miles in South Africa, we do kilometers. Okay? I'm sure you've heard people saying, geez, I've got on the scale and I was horrified to see that I weighed 160 pounds. What's a pound? Okay. And those are things we're going to look at. Converting an empirical system that's used in the United States a unit or into a system that we understand. So that's going to be part of the fun that we're going to experience today as well. Alright? Okay. So that's the first thing. Revise how to convert measurements. Then we also going to look at time. Alright? And that is an important concept, especially with our next section. And our next section, we're going to be looking at tables. Train timetables or airport tables, or rather aeroplane timetables, okay, and also bus timetables, and we're going to have to figure out different routes, and also know how long is the flight from Durban to, let's say, Potchefstroom. I don't know why you'd want to go to Potchefstroom, but if you had to, okay, or how far is the bus route from Johannesburg to Paul, or Stellenbosch, and so we need to be able to calculate different times, okay. Let's go on. So, we've discussed our challenge question. I just want to point out something to you quickly, and I'm going to use a different color. Here we go. Kevin's visiting his sister in the United States. He's driving on a road and notices he's traveling at an average speed of 80 miles an hour. Remember earlier I said to you, seriously, what's this 80 mile stuff? Okay? Now, given that 1 mile is 1.609 kilometers, determine if Kevin will complete a trip of 420 kilometers by 4:30 if he left home at 1:15. I love this question because it involves time, it involves changing units, and it also looks at different systems. The metric system, okay, as well as the funny weird system they use in America. All right, but let's first look at our summary. What we're going to do in this lesson is we're going to spend a few minutes just doing a bit of recap, going through some stuff. After the air break, we're going to then look at a few problems. And then after that another air break, so we have two air breaks today. After our second air break, I'm going to be here to answer any questions which you may have. And please, I'm going to ask you to ask Ibrahim those questions. How do they ask you all that?
Facebook or on Twitter, just Twitter.
Okay, so you can tweet
That's a cool word.
You can tweet or SMS them or BDM them or whatever you've got to do on that computer thing, and then he will tell me, and we'll go through those questions. Okay, cool. Let's have a look at this. Before we do this, boys, how are we doing?
Pretty good.
Pretty good. You're doing all right. Yes. Okay, explain what you've done so far. Just hold that piece of paper up.
So, basically, all it was is the 10 centimeters this way, 10 up here, curving in 10 centimeter block around each way. So then this top one, the reason why it's 10 is because it has to be the top piece for the top of the block.
Okay, we don't really have to have a top.
So
we need that for
the top. You just cut it off. Just add an umbrella.
Yeah, that would be the bottom piece of the
thing. So, yeah, and then basically each block is 10 centimeters.
Okay, so what's your goal now? Now you're getting
power, you're going to cut it off, and then fold it up, and then just stick it up.
And then
hopefully you see it.
Yes. Well, everyone's hoping you're going to see it. Okay. All right, great guys. You carry on. I'll keep talking to you. Right, folks. Now, let's have a look. We're going to look at weight, and what we're going to say about weight is this, that we have something called a base unit. And a base unit is the unit, and we could say we start with, okay? So in weight, I'm going to start at grams. And I'm either going to go heavier into kilograms, or I'm going to go lighter into milligrams, okay? So if I start at grams, I go heavier into kilograms or lighter into milligrams. My length, we can start at meters. I can go longer into kilometers. I'm going to go to the next one.
grab. So we got to kill the fancy grab. We get to put grab, grab, and grab. Now, joke. The top from kindergarten, grab, and what? No one can make it back out. just so you've got an update, this is what the box is going to get to look like. A pretty impressed. I really am. It looks good. Hopefully, you'll have to be a quick player to play the box. You guys know what the box is going to look like. And just try to fix it up a little bit. Don't be prepared to go to the aisle. But don't come out of the box. You're always happy. Talking about my brand before the break, and my brand talks to you. If I put my stuff on, my stuff looks good. simple, isn't it? Absolutely best. Because everything we need to be aware of at the first point, including the first step, this is like an introduction to this. They don't get a lot of these straightforward basic things from reading this to this to that. But they might ask you a huge question when you go to these basic things. So, now, let's go on. Converting each of the following to grade. Now what we've got is to deal with math. Do you remember? We've got grades, we've got mixed grades, and we've got pivot grades. And we said the jump was 1,000, and then the jump was 1,000. When I'm going this way, I'm dividing. When I'm going into 4 minutes, I'm going to need to multiply. Now we've got kilograms, we want to change it to grams. Kilograms to grams, we get into grams, and I multiply them by 1,000. When I multiply them by 1,000, I get 85,000 grams. Have you? Okay. Next thing. Convert 600 milligrams to grams. We're traveling from milligrams to grams. We get a divide, and we get a divide by 1,000. So when I divide that by 1,000, and again, it's the all the little zero commas in your way to calculate it. Okay. So we've got 600. Divide that now by 1,000 equals, and we end up with an answer of 0.6. Let's look at our next one. Now, here we go with kilometers and miles, etc. Here's the question. I think you almost finished your book. Almost finished. Just so you can kind of give me a wave when you're reading. Jerry Lucas put up there and said to me, how many decimal places might be round to? Boy, you're good. And some boys were quite annoyed with me. And they were saying, sir, you never told me how many decimal places. Am I right, Jerry? But they didn't have to know how many decimal places. Why not? We don't have to run a clinical appearance, and when we make a comparison, you know, we don't care how many people places we go. What's that for, you think? Okay? And what some of you guys might be thinking is, hey, it's rounded to one decimal place. If you round that to one decimal place, you're going to get 103.5 kilometers. And we want to know which is further, 103.5 or the mile. Now, if you round that or to one decimal place, you're going to get 103.5. And you're actually going to draw a conclusion and say, you know what? That is going to fall in length. But that is not equal in length. This is dropping. So I don't have to round off. I'm going to do, well, you know what? That is wrong. So I'm going to start say, well, that's the answer. Therefore, I know that 64 comma 3 in my own. There's a long guy. There. I'm going to do 6 comma 5 comma. Let me think that my voice has followed himself when they finish every single question in that test of the test. Okay? We're going to see if they just look straight into the camera and tell the truth. What are the key things you always ask yourself when you finish the question? Number one, just look at this. Does my answer make sense? Absolutely. Okay? Number two, I'm going to use it this way. Now I'll go for this one. This is the most important question. Have I answered the question? That's important. Because this question says it is 64 comma 3 miles further than 106 comma 5 kilometers. It's not as if you're getting there and the answer is stopping green off the course without examining. You haven't answered the question. The question is it further? My answer is absolutely it is further. And then the question that we ask our internet was for interest. Why am I around? So, guys, once again, it is? Doesn't make sense. Doesn't make sense. Have you answered the question? Have I answered the question? And make sure you have an answer. You have an well done, guys. Maybe I don't have a piece of foot on the camera. You always keep trying to cross the line. Okay. So, how about that? It's going to say this. We have confused the box. We have every single one of our next questions and benefit from it. Because in order to answer this question, we've got to do this experiment. That's the question. Which is great. Container A holds 1.2 gallons. Which is a rectangular prism, the size 50 centimeters by 102 millimeters by a corridor of 500 meters. Now, before we turn on to that question, there's a certain concept we have to understand. Okay. Now, our poor cameraman is going to be running around the place to do all we can. Brendan, you're going to disconnect your signs, so if it does mean it doesn't mix up our multi-million brain signs system. So everyone's no longer going to be talking to you, so I'll do all the talking. Maybe that's a good thing, so when you squeeze the salt water and dust it off the rim, you won't hear me. Everyone's going to lie on the floor. It looks like those are taking out the mics. They don't have very much faith in you guys. Doesn't look good. All right. So, Brendan, here you are. You've got a lot of you two guys. If you don't mind coming around here, because we're going to be placing this camera right over there. Brendan, you're going to lie down. You're going to stay by sniffing. We can't get hands on the floor. Let's get down checks so we all press it to the start. Brendan, you're just going to lie down. We're ready to go. All the wires are on the way. That now, guys, is a cube. We're changing a cube. Okay? In other words, the length of brick and the height are presumably the same. So if I've got a room that measures the height, it can be 10 centimeters, right? Presumably, it will be 6 meters. The length will be, and the brick will be. Okay. You may just chuck your waterproof. Okay. Now, the idea here, and we're just doing the waterproof thing as a bit of a joke here, and a bit of fun to the lesson, okay? We'll have to do this in class as well. All right. But the idea behind this is to figure out how much water we can put into this tiny little block. Now, what I've got here is I've got a liter of water. You can see the markings. We've got quarter of a liter, half a liter, 3/4 of a liter, and a whole liter. Now, if obviously half of this fits in, we know it contains half of a liter. Yeah, 3/4 of this contains. Okay. So I'm not going to have any part in this because I'm not too distant. So what, who would like to pour the water? So John's going to pour the water. All right. He's going to have a cup.
you are going to hold this over Everett. And you might have folded it at the bottom, otherwise it's not. Okay? Right over him, and we're going to stick it.
Now, remember, guys, the main idea behind this is not so much how much water he trapped, but how much water goes in. Because we have to try and see how much water can be held in a container that seems to be in this but seems to be in this particular thing. Good luck. Right, let's do it.
Program's very tough, but you feel pouring water.
That's fantastic. Now we've got a little bit of a heat, but that's okay. I'm going to keep talking. Now, folks, the most amazing thing that just happened, we fit an entire liter of water into this funny little box that's 10 centimeters by 10 centimeters by 10 centimeters. Well, it looks like you're getting wet there, my pal.
You're right.
It's great.
It's nice and refreshing, isn't it?
No, it's empty.
All right, so we put them under the lid.
No, it's not. I'm going to ask you to pull that in here. I'm going to hold it over in the back while just get a little more
fun. Okay, Abraham, there we go.
Fantastic.
Now, friend, you're going to have to wire up while I talk, because no one's going to get anything to do with it.
Okay, cool. I'm heading back to my cabin here, guys. You can see on your little table. I'll be looking at all of this.
There we go.
Okay, so, besides all the fun we have, we could actually improve the system. That if I have a box 6 centimeters by 10 centimeters by 10 centimeters, it fits a whole meter of water per second.
Okay,
which really boggles the mind.
Okay,
let me say this and put it in another way. That little box, do we still have it? This little box,
they've got the names here, one being James, so I think it's the other way.
This little box, which is kind of got a little funny cooked with, can contain a whole box of milk. That just boggles the mind. Okay? In fact, if you've got a tin of Coke, this box can contain nearly 3 tins of that Coke. Okay. I mean, one tin of Coke is quite cool, it's quite refreshing. 3 tins of Coke are freaking wonderful.
Yeah. Thing, just pull that with Coke, it's got stuff to ask you for a day. Well, in your case, a few minutes to not
be able to do it. Okay. So, I want to draw this up here quickly.
Now, this will make more space.
Right. So, I have a box. Yes, here it is. 10 centimeters by 10 centimeters by 10 centimeters. So what is the volume of that box?
Now, the volume of the cube. Volume is equal to.
And what is my length? Cool.
And my breadth?
And my height?
What is 10 times 10 times 10?
1,000. Right. 1,000 centimeters.
Brilliant.
Why? Two things. Number one, we're dealing with volume, and we know volume is always cubic. And number two, you can see you've got 3 centimeters. That's one thing. One and there's one. 12 times 0. Okay? So it's 1,000 centimeters cubic. And we have just proved that 1,000 centimeters cubic is equal to 1.
I've got to say that it has a huge impact on the mathematical world. Now what we can do is we can calculate the volume of a swimming pool and be able to work out how many liters are in that pool. Okay? Let's do that. So let's pretend we're going to look and try to figure out how much water fits inside a limited size swimming pool.
Cool.
Right. Guys, you know how big a limited size swimming pool is. Okay? What is the length of Olympic size swimming pool? We don't want it to go 30 meters, 50 meters, broken. The breadth, excellent. And the height, for the length of 2 feet, okay?
To 2 feet.
All right, so we've got 2 meters. Now, we're going to take out our calculator because I don't want to miss out here. I don't know what I've just done here. We've got to go into the calculator.
Oh,
So we said we've got 7 meters multiplied by 25 meters multiplied by 2 meters, and we add up with 2,500 watts. But I know this is my problem. What is my problem, folks? Look at the camera. You don't want to see the front of you. Yeah, there we go. So basically, you've got 7 meters cubed. What about the 7 meters cubed? I said 2,500 meters. Before we can work with this formula, we've got to add 10 meters cubed. Yeah, we've got meters cubed. Now, we've got to change 50 meters into meters cubed. How do we do it? We are going that 50 meters to meters. What's the jump? Change from 100 meters. I mean, you're a little bit memory, but that is for one stop. How many stops did I do? Three. It's got an end, a break, and a stop. So it's not just converting the one stop. We're converting both the length and the break and the height. So we're not just doing this change 100 times. We're doing it 100 and 100. Do we agree on that? So, let's have a look. From 20 meters to meters, or from meters to 20 meters, do I expect my monitor to get bigger or smaller? I'm sorry, from what's that? From meters to 20 meters. So, they're getting bigger. Much bigger. Makes sense. Okay. So, we've got 2,500. We're going to multiply that by 100 and another 100 and another 100. And our answer, now guys, if you like me, you're going to get confused with all the zeros. So, it's 7, plus 1. So, times 100, times, equals, how long did you have it? I have to say, we've got this question expressed. It was 1 or 2, or you can answer the question, you can do it. It's quite a good number, okay? The 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 zeros. Okay? So, we got this big number. 2, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 zeros. Sure. But that's now 60 meters. Now, what are we going to do with that? We're going to take a huge number. We've got all those zeros divided by 1,000 to work out how many. So divide that by 1,000, and let's just use our calculator again. We're going to say divide by 1,000, and now we get one with a little problem. So we've got 2,500,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000, Right, great. Thanks, folks. Welcome back. I'm sure you're back. If you listen to me, you're back. Okay. So, just before the outbreak, we had some about fine pouring water into a little container. Okay. And the reason we did that was to be able to answer this question that's fine. You get given a few containers. told the Facebook chat
it contained 5,900 milliliters of water.
He told the second container was 1.3 gallons.
Okay.
The sixth container had almost 5,900 milliliters.
Then the third container, they all tell you how much milliliters of the diameter of the container. And take a look at it. They tell you that the containers of intentional prison from size 15 centimeters by 102 millimeters by 0.5 liters.
Now, what's the first part of this?
I ain't here with you in grade 10, 11, or 12.
You cannot answer any questions. Unit measurement is your units are not the same. So let's make them the same. What unit would you suggest? Let's ask money for this money. What unit would you suggest? Would you be millimeters, centimeters, or meters?
Centimeters.
What?
I suggest them. I don't know, sir.
Container contain a beam toll of 5,900 meters. How do we convert millimeters to inches?
Divided by 5,000 is 1,000
meters. If I was 5,000, what am I going to get here?
5.9 meters.
Which contains more?
Guys, during the outbreak, I said that we were getting heated questions and trying to figure out the answer. And James Baldwin said, well, if you don't have a
driving on a road, and those roads are turning at an average speed of 80 kilometers an hour, miles an hour.
Okay, so that means it's just jump quickly.
Right. Now, we're told that 1 mile is 1.69 kilometers. We want to know, what's the finish of this trip? This has got to travel 420 kilometers from 4 cities, by 4 cities, to be total at 1.32. Now, the first thing we've got to do is determine how the balance is traveling with geometric groups. How are we going to do that? Well, we're going to see just the most important thing that we're going to do. If you're going to be worried about the time, I'm going to talk
about it. Okay. So, we're going to have to go to the
hall. Well, 1.18 to 4.6. How does it get to 4.6?
Is this going to be worth every moment? 1.1.
Okay. Okay. 4 hours, 30 minutes, minus 1 hour, 32 minutes, and that's the term of 1 hour. We can use it on the calculator, and this is easy. And so now we can raise further away from this calculator. Okay? Because when he releases them down, which is quite often, he says we know use the calculator. So guys, this calculator is wonderful because it has a time feature. Okay? And the time feature is going to help us. We're going to say 4 hours. This is the time button. It's got a flat little circle and a comma and a comma and a comma, right? Hopefully you can see it on the screen. So, 4 hours, 30 minutes, and raw seconds. We then need to subtract the time that you take. What time did you take from this? We've got to say 1 hour, 15 minutes, and raw seconds, which means it took us, oh my goodness, I've made so much time in the week, I've made mistakes, I'm frantically writing, because it's going to be down to 52 seconds. Okay, so we now need to do our challenge question. That's just absolutely horrific. I can't believe it. It's not like actually, but we always have so much fun to run on stories. The answer will be put up on this computer thing of yours. You will find the answer. I'm sorry, but the story is going to keep us in suspense and not tell us how long it is. Okay, we'd like to really see this, guys. Before I say goodbye, I just want to say the challenge of one. Thanks very much, guys. It's been great having you in this studio. Really great. The dog is going to come up as well. So, this is a visual of a few dogs on the bus. It's a little bit less. It's a little bit more than this. Because it's a little bit more than this. We don't want to come up to get in here. But last year, we just said, yes,